Joining me right now, the former Republican governor of Ohio, former presidential candidate John Kasich. He's now CNN senior political commentator. Great to see you, Governor.
Kate, I'll tell you what I think is interesting. I'm going to get to your question here, but, you know, I'm not surprised. I predicted, I'm a great predictor, but, you know, on State of the Union night, I said I believe the conferees would reach agreement, and they have. That's because when you put people in a room, and I've been in those rooms and been involved in many negotiations, that they were able to reach an agreement. Now, the question is the president going to sign it? Now, my view is, if I were to predict this one, I would say that he will sign it, and he will try then to move money that is, you know, perhaps in the Department of Defense to try to do more for the wall. And that's how he'll try to mollify his who will become critics on the right. But it's very interesting that they reached agreement. No surprise. Nobody wants to go through another government shutdown. And then, of course, the debate about the wall. Beto, you know, down there in Texas, remember, he's a Texas Democrat. So he's not really, you know, he's pretty moderate. He's pretty smart in the fact that he picks those issues that he thinks resonates with his base. And the question for Beto going forward is, what's his lane? How is he willing to present himself?
And that's what I wanted to ask. I mean, from what you've seen and what you saw last night, if you were in his shoes, if you were looking at the field that is out there right now, would you jump in?
Well, considering the fact that I've run for president, the answer is what is he comfortable with? Does he apparently has the fundraising base, maybe. Because remember, he was running against Ted Cruz in Texas. So the issue, the real issue is, can he maintain that fundraising base? Is he unique and what's his lane? So in other words, you have a number of people now who are kind of on the left. You know, they're Medicare for all, they're for the Green Plan and all this stuff, and maybe, you know, wealth tax or whatever. Where does Beto put himself? Is he going to compete over there, or is he going to compete a little bit more in the middle? Because remember, Will Hurd, who's the congressman who borders his district, he did not go out and support the Democrat opponent. That strikes a more moderation. So the question is, can Beto be both a moderate and yet appeal to progressives at the same time? That's what he's, I'm sure he's asking himself. And is he in for this kind of a campaign? Does his family want him to do it? Because, you know, Kate, people say, oh, you ought to just run for president. You don't just run for president. It's very, very difficult. It takes a lot of time. It's excruciatingly hard. But at the same time, it can be an incredibly great experience.
I mean, and you've run in a crowded field for the White House before. I mean, what do you think? Is that your biggest lesson? Know what you're going to get into, and that it's a long slog. But what was your biggest lesson in how you stand out in a crowded field?
Well, for me, what I learned in the campaign is, first of all, I won my lane, and the only person that beat me in New Hampshire was Donald Trump, and so that was a pretty good win. But when I went down to South Carolina, we didn't get any coverage. No one knew who I was in the South, so I had very little name ID. And the states were so big, I couldn't break through. But what I learned in the campaign is this. It's not about this specific policy proposal or some other. It's about the way that people feel about you. And I am convinced, in an era of ever-changing economics, people want to know, do you care about me? And that's why it's important that Republicans have answers, real good answers on health care, why they have really good answers on what we're going to do about the growing gap between the rich and the poor. And the question is, how does this all finally work out? But in the beginning, you got to tell people who you are, and they got to kind of like you, and you have to have a spark. I think Beto, from what I understand, people like him. But where does that go once he's out there really competing against people who are farther to the left?
Well, I'm looking at Republican ideas, if you will. One name that's been floated out there as a potential Republican primary challenger to President Trump is Maryland Governor Larry Hogan, other than yourself, has been floated out there as well. Let me play you what Larry Hogan told Aaron Burnett last night.
Look, I'm flattered that people are talking about that, Aaron, but I haven't, as I've said before, I haven't really given much thought to that at all.
It's not a no, as we say. What do you think of Governor Hogan?
It wasn't a very good yes either. He said, I haven't really thought about it. Well, you know, you have to think about it. You have to have things in place. I mean, where are your supporters? Who are they? Can you raise the money? What's the primary schedule? How do you compete?
So most important question of the day. Most important question of the day, Governor. I've noticed from Twitter that you have now taken up yoga. Has yoga brought you any more clarity about your decision? When you've told me last time I saw you 2 weeks ago that all options were on the table for you.
You know, everybody's talking about the fact that I'm on Instagram talking about things that are important to me. And, you know, yoga was one of them. I mean, I'm going to keep at yoga. But, I posted something the other day. I went with my wife to see the iconic singer Cher. And popping up in the beginning of her show was her relationship with Sonny Bono. I was very good friends with Sonny. He and I were in Congress together. We hung out a lot together. We laughed. He was a very wise guy in many different ways. And I think that the Instagram gives you an opportunity not just to put some silly thing up there, which sometimes people do, but I think what people want to know is who are you? And that's what's exciting about Instagram if you use it in the right way.
And now, John Kasich, governor and yogi, is one thing that we have learned from that. Great to see you, Governor. We'll see you soon.
Right,
thank you.
Kate, always good to be with you. Thank you.
Talk to you soon. Coming up, lawmakers have...